Costa Rica opened our eyes to... You gotta hold on to what you got, babe. It ain't always cleaner on the other side, you know. We ain't rich, but we worth a lot, babe. Wanna see the world with your hand in mine, you know. Come on, I love you like that. It ain't always cleaner on the other side, you know. Come on, I love you like that. I wanna see the world with your hand in mine, you know. Stop number one was Costa Rica, right? We're there for a month. We stayed in an area called Punta Leona. It's just north of Jaco, like about 20 minutes.
We did a house with bedrooms for the kids.
No, bedrooms. You don't need a house, you just need a beach and a pool. But we booked this place that had supposedly had a membership to a club, which turns out wasn't really a membership to a club, as we found out. And we were...
Well, it was a membership. It was their membership.
That's true. That they were letting us borrow.
But we didn't know we weren't supposed to.
So we just got kicked out of the club because we didn't have the correct passes. They looked at us. They were like, you're white. You don't belong here. So let's double check on your passes. And ended up finding out in our little neighborhood that there was another pool, which ended up being... so much
awesome.
Better.
We loved the neighborhood pool. It was so cool.
And the big part about that was the kids and their swimming abilities skyrocketed once they started swimming pretty much every day. And their confidence got built up. But by the end of the trip, I mean, yeah, they're swimming across the entire pool. Subway train, first dance in the summer rain, from city lights to nowhere roads, it doesn't matter where we go. You and me, we got that little bit of everything.
So fun to see their confidence just skyrocket.
We wanted to go back to this place called Arenal, La Fortuna, and there's a big volcano there, which you can, it's often in the clouds, or at least the top part is in the clouds, but we wanted to go back.
So we drove from Punta Leona to Arenal, and we didn't look at the path that it was going to have us take. We just were like, straight a shot, right?
Google Maps.
Google Maps.
Type in the Google
we want
map.
The shortest.
Cool.
Shortest path possible. It was a wild, wild ride.
Yeah, I wasn't sure on a couple of times if it really was going to make it up. We were going up these just crazy switchbacks and having the pedal to the floor
and still
barely
just crawling
up these
so
things.
So slow.
But we made it though, and it was fun, and it was a definite memory that we'll never forget.
And we wish we had footage.
Yeah, sorry about that. We just stayed for one night. And
Lagos.
Yeah, we went to a hot spring kind of resort. And then we also, on our way out, we hiked to a waterfall. And
it's about 500 steps down and 500 steps back up. And we had to, anytime we're going to do a hike like that, we kind of try and prep the kids and, hey, so this is going to be 500 steps. Do you think you can do it? And kind of get them psyched about, like, oh, yeah, the challenge of it. And they totally rocked the hike down. Colby carried crew on the way back up. But Zoe was really cute and counted the steps on our way back up. So they loved the waterfall, and they, Colby and crew, did crew get in the water with you?
Yep.
Swam at the bottom
crew
of the waterfall.
Crew wanted to swim, so we took off our clothes and went swimming. We got that little bit of everything, little bit of everything. Hey, I see
is you and me.
Steps. 24,
26. How many steps are there, Zoe?
500. So another place that we wanted to go that we had been when it was just the two of us before we had kids was Manuel Antonio.
So we get there. It's really crowded. Everyone seems like is... It kind of felt like people were all just lying to you to try to get your money. And yeah, we just weren't in the best mood. And then getting there and arriving there, and there was just so many more people and just so crowded compared to the first time that we went.
And we didn't pay for a guide. So the last time we had paid for a guide and we saw tons of animals and we loved it. And so we had these glorified memories of like, oh, we saw these animals. We have to take our kids back. They're going to love it. And this time we talked to people who had said like, oh yeah, we didn't take a guide and we saw all these animals. And so we're like, okay, cool. We'll save a whole bunch of money, not pay for a guide, and see all these animals with our kids. They're gonna love it, whatever. About an hour and a half in, we had seen the head of a frog and a lizard. Yeah, our kids weren't so thrilled with us.
They were, we had kind of hyped it up a lot that we were gonna see a bunch of animals.
They weren't very happy.
So they started eating rocks.
They were really hungry, and so they started playing gay with each other and eating rocks. Like, not swallowing, but like licking rocks. Just like picking them off the ground, licking rocks. And we were like, we just gotta get to the beach. We just gotta get to the beach. So keep going, guys. Keep going. We promise. You'll see some animals. And we did. We saw monkeys, and it was amazing. It always is amazing. So fun to see these wild monkeys all over. Little babies on the backs and on the stomachs, and they're just like jumping through the trees.
Stealing everyone's food. Stealing whatever they can get their hands on.
Yeah.
Or they'll dig through your backpack. They'll take your bags.
Holding on to. Yeah. Or grab it out of your hands. So it was really fun to see the monkeys.
I see the magic in your everything, little bit of everything.
We try to pick really good locations for the places that we stay, and that usually is always by the beach for me, because I'm usually the one that starts the initial search and I'm like, closest to the beach. In Punta Leona,
there are two beaches, Playa Mantis and Playa Blanca, separated by this little peninsula. And Playa Blanca you can only get to either by staying at a resort or crossing over this little peninsula from Playa Mantis.
Yeah.
Playa Mantis and Playa Blanca are two of the most beautiful, pristine beaches.
And it's where a lot of the locals go.
In Costa Rica. And it's where a lot of the locals go to vacation. So it's a little bit off the radar. And I almost am like, should I tell people? Because, like, I'm sure the locals don't want all the tourists coming to their beaches because they're so beautiful.
Yeah. You're welcome.
We belong together. Places that their best friends go, and every time you go away, I never wanna say goodbye. So we take it slow, let the seeds of love that's grow till the day that we both knew. Gonna say goodbye.
Costa Rica opened our eyes to Pipa.
Oh yeah.
Pipa Fria.
The Pipa Fria.
So
you go
good.
To Costa Rica, do not miss the Pipa Fria. I don't, just in case you don't know, Pipa Fria is fresh coconut water.
Yeah.
They're
so
about,
much better.
About a dollar, usually like 500 to 600 colones, which is about $1.
Contrast that with going to Hawaii,
where you can get one for
$10.
Yeah.
Even just sitting here now, like, I want to go back.
Yeah. Yeah. We loved it. And it's funny in hindsight how those hard times and the things that make it kind of like, are we crazy that we did this? You look back and you just laugh and you just like remember all the good things. You're like, man, that was awesome. I want to go back.
You gotta hold on to what you got, babe. It ain't always greener on the other side, you know. We ain't rich, but we worth a lot, babe. Wanna see the world with your hand in mine, you know. Come on now, love you like that. It ain't always greener on the other side, you know.
One story that I've mentioned to a couple people and then realized that Colby cut it out of our other footage because he wants to erase this memory. One night, I think it was maybe Christmas Eve, we were totally exhausted. We'd gotten the kids to bed finally. We were hugging in the kitchen and it was dark. The lights were off. We were hugging and he was up against the counter and I was hugging. And I see something crawling along the counter, like towards his back. And we had these huge ants of the garden, like big old ants, all over the counter. They'd come out at nighttime. They'd be on the counter and the floor and everywhere. So originally I'm thinking, oh, it's an ant. But then I noticed it has a long thing on the end of its tail. And I'm like, that looks like it moves different than an ant. So I flip on the light. Sure enough, scorpion crawling right toward his back, like probably a foot away from being at him. And I'm like, that's a scorpion. And so we got rid of it, and we were glad the scorpion didn't invade our hug, but we'll forever remember that as the scorpion hug.